It opened in 1930, a lavish explosion of Spanish mission with sumptuous interiors for viewing pleasure, an entertainment palace, as movies transitioned from the silent age to the talkies.
Before the movie was screened, there would be a prologue, a live show, perhaps a musical entertainment, something like that.
But in 2019, the Roxy lies fallow, grass taking root beneath the neon. After previous lives as a multiplex, schnitty restaurant, nightclub and pub. But lying fallow in Parramatta is a construction anathema as the city springs with new towers. One more proposed for the Roxy.
By all means, build a tower, but not in such a way that it's going to destroy the inside of the Roxy.
After the development plan was rejected by Parramatta Council, the parties involved met in this car park yesterday to try to find common ground.
To be able to bring this theatre back to its former glory, we cannot have a tower of that size right through the heart of this building.
And with council plans to feature it as part of a new pedestrian plaza, Roxy fans are now calling for state intervention.
I don't think the private sector is going to save it by themselves. I think the government needs to step up to the plate and save the theatre.
The case of the Roxy and its future now heads to the Land and Environment Court, but with five separate heritage orders in place, at this stage, it's only the lawyers getting their tickets clipped at the Roxy. Mike Dalton, Nine News.